And so I want you to put your hands together for Joey Gilbert.
Can everybody hear me out there? Right on. Well, I am very excited to be here. This is actually my third time at AMP. So I just want to say good evening to everybody, and I hope you have enjoyed your time in Miami. I know I have, for sure. We've got a lot of energy and excitement in the room, and that gives me a lot of hope for this country, for America, the country we love, and the president of these United States that is fighting for us every single day. Now, I want you guys to understand something. I'm here to discuss something with you very, very briefly. It's what I call the championship formula. And I've spent my entire life perfecting this, my entire young adult life, perfecting this. And so before I continue to introduce myself, I want everybody to do something for me. Everybody in the room, take a deep breath real quick and do this for me. I want you to close your eyes. Just go with me on this. Close your eyes. Ask yourself, what was or what is your biggest challenge? What have you done or what are you doing to meet that challenge and be successful? And third, are you a champion? That simple. Are you a champion? Okay, I'm going to be showcasing some important quotes here tonight. Do we not have no quotes? Okay, well, it doesn't sound like we have some quotes here. But I have a quote. It's one I've been using my entire life. It's a Muhammad Ali quote. And he says, Muhammad Ali says, I don't count the sit-ups. I only start counting when it starts hurting, because those are the ones that count. And that's what makes you a champion. And let me tell you what that means to me. All right? When we say that we don't start counting till it hurts, it's because a champion means you don't quit, you don't give up, right? And so a good friend of mine, actually a mentor, someone who's total inspiration to me, Sugar Ray Leonard, the Sugar Man, said to me on the set of NBC's The Contender, along with Sylvester Stallone, if you guys are putting things together yet, he said to me that as a champion, you have to decide if you want to go in that deep, dark, black hole where it's cold, lonely, where it's scary, where it hurts. And if you want to decide, you're going to make that decision to come out or not. And I'll tell you this, man, in my time, in my career as a fighter, I've chosen to come out many times. And if you haven't made that choice before, by the end of tonight, you will. You'll start making that choice each and every time. So before we go any further, I want to talk a little bit about myself. I'm from Chicago, but I moved to Reno, Nevada when I was young, before college. On a dare from my fraternity brothers, I actually joined the boxing team at 19 years old. I went on to become a world champion years later, and now I'm an attorney in Reno who has actually filed 3 lawsuits against our governor. And I'm taking his butt to the Ninth Circuit. And I'm taking him to the Supreme Court of Nevada. Because we are not going to lay down, and we are going to stay in the trenches and keep punching, because that's what we do. So, let me just say this. I'm an entrepreneur in the cannabis realm, and I want Republicans to try and understand and come forward a little bit on cannabis, because it's going to help things in a big way. All right? And I've also been a community advocate, a promoter. I actually work with V. Roy Jones Jr. from Pensacola, Florida, is a partner of mine. We do boxing together. I have a real estate company, and my early success came as a young attorney when I spent my entire life savings on billboards and let it rip. I ended up with 10 bar violations that year and put about 9 businesses out of business, 9 law firms out of business, but we kept rolling. And so I believed in myself, and ever since then, it's been a wrap. Now, if there's a slide here. I joined the Air Force back in, I think it was 2001, 2000, and my father, a retired colonel, in the Marine Corps tells me all the time that this didn't count. The colonel tells me that I was kind enough to give him and his army buddies a ride when they need to go somewhere. So we love the colonel. But I would just say this, that there's some pictures, guys, I want you to see. This is me overseas touring. I got to do a lot of fun stuff as a professional athlete, as a world champion. But one of the things that I value most was going on these USO tours to see our men and women in uniform. By far, you want to talk about one of the coolest moments. I've been on private jet, G4 jets. I've been with Stallone. I've been with Justin Timberlake. I've been with them all. That was the greatest time I ever had, hands down. Getting over to spend some time with people. You want to talk about true sacrifice? Try leaving your family for 4, 5, 9 months and getting extended to 13. coming home to two new kids, right? So the bottom line is this. Yeah. The one that you, because you were gone too long is what I'm getting at. And it happened a lot. So let me say this. I was an undefeated boxer in college. I was a three-time national champ. I was a four-time All-American. I won the Golden Gloves in 2000. I went on to win the WBO NABO belt, the WBC USNBC. I was ranked number 3 in the world by the WBO and number 7 in the world by the WBC, which is the money belt that Floyd talks about because that's what gets you paid. That's what does. Yes, sir. So why I'm talking about this here today, why I'm here, is because I think I was brought in for a little bit of motivation, a little bit of inspiration. We are facing tough times, and I'll tell you this, as you already heard, they have outnumbered us. They have outgunned us. They're better financed. I don't know what we've been doing, but we better get going. And we better get going quickly, all right? And so I want to tell you guys something. This is going to lead into how I got where I am and why I believe I'm where I'm at. And it has to do with my 3 points. I'm going to talk about the 3 things that we do, my 3 daily steps for success daily. But I want to first back up. You saw the Stallone picture. Can we go back to the Stallone picture? So right here, this is going to kind of put into words and put into context what I'm getting at when I say make a move, when I say hit the ground each day with conviction and determination. And so I want you guys to know this. I was at a fight in Las Vegas, and anybody that knows anything about boxing, when there's a fight and the fighter that you're supposed to go to the after party loses, that after party really doesn't happen the way it was supposed to happen, right? Fighter loses. So I'm all dressed up. I'm in a suit. I'm at the Mandalay Bay. I'm out talking. I'm out rubbing elbows. That's what you do when you're an entertainer. You're trying to pick up sponsors, trying to pick up other gigs, trying to talk to promoters. And sure as shit, Stallone is eating dinner in a restaurant called Lupe, Italian restaurant in Mandalay Bay. Anybody knows Mandalay Bay? It was right outside Rum Jungle. And he's in there, and I'm there with another attorney and another friend of mine that sells timeshares, and they said, hey, why don't you go in there and tell Stallone you want to be on the Contender? Why don't you go in there, big shot? Why don't you go tell him? Come on, champ. So that's a dare, right? That's a dare. I'm staying outside there. Whew. I'm doing this. I'm like, all right, I'm going to do it. I'm going to go. I'm going to get to him. And there's this ginormous security guard. I remember thinking, I'm going to fake to the left. I'm going to spin out to the right and get to him. I did it. I see Stallone. I come in. I start to go this way. Spin around. All of a sudden, right here, I come down like this. I put out my hand. I tap his leg. This is no bullshit in Lupe. I say, Mr. Stallone, my name's Joey Gilbert. I'm a 3-time national champ, 4-time All-American. I won the Golden Gloves in 2000. I just finished law school. I also have my degree in English literature. I understand you had a degree in English literature, Mr. Stallone, as well. And you also tried to get, they also tried to kick you out of the Catholic school like they did me. And I said, I finished the Air Force Reserve. I just finished law school. I took the bar exam, but I don't have my results yet. And I'm 7-0 with 7 knockouts as a professional fighter. He looks at me. He looks down at me. Out of everything he could say, he looks down at me and says, are you Italian? I said, yes. He said, what's with Gilbert? I said, I'm adopted by my stepfather, Dr. Gilbert. Otherwise, my name would be Giuseppe Salvatore Caramonte. And he said, right on. And Sylvester Stallone stood up at the table. And at this table was Jeffrey Katzenberg, Mark Burnett, Sugar Ray Leonard, George Foreman, Conrad Riggs, Jeff Wald. And he said, gentlemen, this is Joey Gilbert. He rattled off my entire CV and said, he will be on our show. I never turned in a video. I never turned in an application. But I made a move. I made a move and went and did what, you know, everyone thought was impossible. And I got myself, I'll never forget that Monday morning about 7:15 a.m. getting a call from a 310 number. It was Mark Burnett's casting office. I got invited out to L.A. to participate in the tryouts, which became quickly the national commercials. I got my SAG card out of this deal, got my Screen Actors Guild card, got cast in the Contender, and the rest is history. So, now that you know that I'm not some schmuck and I'm actually a fighter, I want to discuss my 3 steps to daily success to elevate your life, your business, and your relationships. So, understand this real quick. I was on a flight with Mr. Stallone, Sly, if you know him, right? I was on a flight with Sly, and I remember saying to him, I said, Sly, how do you do it? Anybody seen this man? He's 70 years old now, and he is in the most unbelievable shape you've ever seen in your life. I said, Mr. Stallone, how do you do it? This was the exact quote. Now, I'm going to leave out the F word. But he said, there's those who talk the talk and those who walk the walk. I do whatever it takes, and I operate on a 24-hour clock, just get it done, right? And that's it. At the end of the day, that's what accountability is. Get it done, right? Get it done. So this is my first step. I say this, step number one, get up and get moving. Do not casually stroll into the day. Hit the floor each day with intensity and focus. Meet the challenges of today with purpose and conviction. I'm up about 4:30 a.m. I got my workout in. I got my calls answered. I've done more by 8 a.m. than most of my friends do all week. True story, right? And so what I want to say to you guys is if you do not move, you will be passed by. It does not take very much for your body to react and to get better, to get stronger. And this applies in all facets. The get up, get moving applies to everything. I don't care if it's your work. I don't care if it's your workout routine. I don't care if you're gonna start eating better. I don't care if you need more time with your significant other. I don't even care if you need to spend more time with your kids. Get up and get moving. Stop coasting in that morning and hit the gas pedal to the floor, right? So let me say this. This is a quote I have. A quote is that a champion's heart is made of gold. It means you don't quit and that you fight on. That was something that was important to me because at the end of the day, I have stayed in the trenches to fight. And I've stayed in the trenches with a lot of like-minded people like you all to fight for our president, Donald J. Trump, right? And I apply this three daily steps to everything I'm doing now and suing this governor and pushing back on this complete insanity taking place across our country. And so what I want to say next is this. Step number two. Is do something to better yourself every day. Whether it's a morning workout, meditation, yoga, Pilates, stretching, or just a walk, we all know that we can do better. You just have to execute. At the end of the day, you just have to make a move. Everybody in this room knows what you need to do to be better in business, to be better at home, to be better in your relationship, be better with your kids. You wanna know why you're not doing? Because you're procrastinating. And it's a bunch of bullshit. So knock off the bullshit and get to work, right? So here we go. I wanna say this. From there, I want you to try this. And I challenge any of y'all to do this for 30 days. Start getting up and hitting the day hard. Start making sure you do something to better yourself each and every day. And don't finish without this last critical part. This last critical part is, I want you to take the time to have a conversation filled with love and optimism with a family member, colleague, significant other, or friend. Once you better your health and better your relationships daily, everything else will begin to take shape. Just do it. Okay? Now listen, anyone can train to be a gladiator, but what marks you out is having the mindset of a champion. And let me tell you what this quote means to me. It means that you fight, fight, fight. I had someone ask me today, how many times are you gonna say fight? That's what she said. I'm gonna say fight a lot, but have y'all noticed that if we push back, it's not as easy on the other side, is it? All right? So I'm gonna encourage everybody that's at this conference now to go home and use your platforms. Use your opportunities. I'm not asking you to be rude. I'm not asking you to get loud in people's face, but I'm definitely asking you to push back with a truthful narrative and confront this insanity head on, okay? So now, let me say this. This was my final step to success. And I want you all to know that in order to do this and make it so I didn't, you know, take you guys through 45 minutes, we took about a 60-minute presentation and brought it down to about 25 minutes. So there's stuff that I can elaborate on when you reach out to me, and I will give you the ability to do that. But I wanna say this. The final daily step to success for me is this. It's called pushing the pace. Stay in the pocket. Keep throwing punches. Tackle your objectives with fierceness and conviction. We are all capable of fighting harder and accomplishing more throughout the day. Whatever's on your list, whatever your objectives are, push past those hard and fast. When you stay motivated, you avoid distractions and you give yourself more time for your mental fortitude, and the day opens up to spend time with your loved ones, all right? That's what's important. Now, truly keep fighting and looking for more ways to better yourself and create that edge. And I don't know if you guys have heard of my man David Goggins. Who knows David Goggins? Who's heard of David Goggins? I want you all to write that name down. You look up David Goggins and you read about that man. All right? David Goggins likes to say, stay hard. David Goggins likes to say, stay hard. What I want to say to you guys is stay in it. Stay in it. Too many times we give up. Too many times we think the other side's too loud. They're better organized. They got more people. Stay in the fight. Okay? As Republicans, as supporters of our president, we owe it to him to stay in the fight. Has there been a day yet where you haven't seen Donald J. Trump punching back? Has there ever been a day where you've seen Donald J. Trump lay down? No. So what I'm asking y'all to do is to get active and get aggressive. And I don't mean physical. I mean push back. Because if we do this, if we push the pace, if we stay in the pocket like a fighter says and keep throwing those punches, head down, just moving forward, we're going to win. But if we go back on our heels and we give up, we're going to surrender this great country and all the freedoms we hold dear. And ain't no time for that. Ain't no time for that. So like I said, keep throwing punches, stay focused, and get shit done. Okay? Now listen, it doesn't matter, as you all know, how hard you get knocked down. It don't matter how many times you get knocked down. You wake up, you dust yourself off, and you get back in the game. You get back in the fight. So I just want to say this, as we break this COVID nonsense, as we start getting our normalcy back, we need to start taking back what's ours. You need to start showing up at these city councils, these county commissions, these municipality meetings, and start talking with purpose and conviction about why you love this country. Okay? So let me say this. I guarantee you that if you spend the next 30 days implementing these small steps, that you will see unbelievable results. I'm gonna run through them one more time. Number one, I want you to get up and get moving. Number two, I want you to do something each and every day to better yourself. And that also means it can better your relationship, better your job, better your work environment, but you do something to better yourself every day. And number three, you push the pace. Stay in the pocket, push the pace, and don't stop throwing punches. All right? So I'm gonna say this. Tackle your objectives with fierceness and conviction, and please reach out to me with any success stories or if you want some follow-up real quick. media@joeygilbertlaw.com is how you get a hold of me. media@joeygilbertlaw.com. And for those of you that are writing it down, 775-741-1000. That's my cell number. Use it. Thank you. Kick some ass.